There have been some major developments in medicine and robotics, but together they are forming something totally new: mini organ farms tended by robots. If you're a little scared of the future, this may have shocked you. You know, the idea that we would be able to create organs from stem cells is interesting and sometimes controversial. And the idea that robots are taking our jobs is interesting, but also controversial. But these two things, these two ideas seem to be melding together as a new secret weapon in fighting disease, but also creating human organs for transplant, perhaps.
Right, that could potentially be the future, right? This story goes on to talk about how it's very difficult, and the kind of finesse and fine motor skills that you would need to use stem cells to create, you know, what ultimately turns into kidneys can be done far better and more efficiently and more reliably by robots than by people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, as we look at this story, there, you know, kidney transplants are not uncommon. It's something that comes up, and because people have kidney disease.
We have a colleague whose mother desperately needed a kidney. I mean, it's a real human problem.
Right. And so, you know, being able to grow kidneys and replace people's kidneys could be the start of other replacements for other organs. And where I think is, okay, well, so how long before we are functionally immortal because we could just keep replacing?
But we're going to look old and we're not going to like that, right?
Well, we just haven't replaced the skin yet.
Oh.
Right?
You know what? Maybe humans weren't meant to live forever.
Maybe
which is what we learned from Mr. Delos in Westworld. But in this, I mean, even if we're not getting to the point where we can just have our own organs be replenished again and again, we are learning a lot about how organs function and how organs are able, I mean, in the process of creating them. Organoids are kind of small organs that are created in a lab by these robots. And the robots are able to create them at an unprecedented speed using pluripotent stem cells. So these are stem cells that are able to form, you know, more than one kind of organ, for instance. And it could, the robot would be able to coax the cells to form a certain way, perhaps a kidney, perhaps something else. Right. But in the process of doing this, they are able to introduce the cells into plates filled with 384 miniature walls. And from there, they can create organs, organoids, within just 21 days.
Right. Now, to be clear, these are kind of miniature
versions.
They're tiny. It's kind of a test of concept, right?
Yeah.
They're basically saying, should we decide, like, are we going to be able to create a technology that could grow whole kidneys,
mm-hmm.
right? And this is, I think, kind of the test case,
mm-hmm.
right? Can we at least get this started? What happens if we start this process?
Yeah, I mean, we're not, this is just the beginning of this. This was all published in a paper, by the way, on Thursday in Cell Stem Cell. I don't know why it's called Cell Twice, but it must be very nice. And
it's the Bond, James Bond name.
Cell, stem cell. Which stem cell research is very, I think, promising. And in this, they also learned about the development, when they were developing the kidneys, they found the presence of a myosin inhibitor that caused the development of cysts. And they found how much is that important to muscle contraction and creating the kidneys themselves. So we are learning a lot about these organs.
I'm glad you brought up that myosin inhibitor because it's got a name that is my favorite new word of the day.
Oh, please.
Blebbistatin.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, that's...
Yeah.
I didn't know that word either before, but we are learning new words and learning new things about human biology, and perhaps in the future, this will be the stepping stone into creating immortal man gods that should not be.
Right.
I'm excited for that future.
Until then, that's going to be my go-to nickname for somebody I'm angry at. Listen,
right.
Blebbistatin. I don't want to have to listen anymore. You're guff.
Well, blebbistatins, what are your thoughts on living forever due to your own micro-kidney farms tended by robots? Please let us know on Facebook and Twitter.